Hello guys, welcome to another video for the preparation of a descriptive examination. Again, I'm here with some sample essays. So today's first sample essay that we are going to discuss now is on the topic social interaction and internet. Now, this is again a common topic, a common kind of situation on which the examiner can give you a topic to write an essay on. So basically, you know, with the advent of internet, the actual social interaction of people have really got affected. Really? So yes, that's what we have to write in an essay. Okay. So this is an example of how you will write the essay. The first paragraph, which is going to be a introduction paragraph, first body paragraph, second body paragraph, and then lastly, the conclusion. Now we shall be discussing this entire essay in detail with proper explanation. I'll suggest you the content that you can replace from the given content, the meaning of the words, how you have to write the flow of sentences. So if you get the topic social interaction and internet, the topic can come in variety of manners. They can frame a proper statement that, do you think social interaction has affected by internet? How has internet affected the social interaction or social life of people? The topic will really vary, but in general, the topic will be like this. Okay, so let's start with the introduction of this particular essay. Let's start with the introduction part. Okay, so let's read out. Let me read out this thing. It is evident. Now, evident means it is clear. If you will write the word clear in your examination, examiner will give you marks, but not extra marks, not the marks that you deserve to be a good writer in. So I always tell you that try to use good words in your essay to fetch more marks. So instead of writing clear, you should write evident. It is evident that at present, people are spending a considerable amount of time on internet and thus spending less time with real people. So see, in the beginning of the essay only, we gave a clear hint. We gave a clear hint that we are somewhere going to talk about like interaction or time spending with real people and the time on the internet in this essay. So you gave a brief description in the beginning of the essay only. I strongly agree that although this use of internet has greatly increased the level of communication available, it also has had detrimental. Now, what is the meaning of detrimental? Detrimental means bad, or adverse, you can write adverse effect or detrimental effect, whatever you can write it. So detrimental effects on amount and type of social interaction that take place. All right, students, I'll tell you how you can change the lines in this introduction. You can replace the given part in some other as well. For example, you can start your essay like this. The internet has no doubt been a great help to people. We can now communicate to the person sitting in the other corner of the country or the outside the country or other corner of the world. But this internet, which has brought people close together on an online platform, has taken people away from each other in the real life. Okay, so you can just frame different sentences and you can frame your ideas in a different manner as well. So this is how a suitable introduction should look like. You should not include a lot of ideas in introduction because you are left with some more content to write. That is your body paragraph number one, body paragraph number two. You have to write a lot of content in those parts. Okay, so a lot of students make some mistakes. What they do, they give more idea in introduction only. And there are some students who write the introduction, but the introduction does not contain their main topic. So you should not do both. You should be in the mid. You should neither have to give a lot of information, nor you have to keep a brief information. You have to give a just short and sweet idea of what is going to be ahead in the essay. All right. Now let's move on to the first paragraph. Okay. First body paragraph. The body paragraph is generally larger than introduction because this is the part that covers most of the information about your topic. So now, as you know, our topic is the social interaction and internet. So our focus should be more on what? On the internet, because it is the internet which has affected the social interaction of people. So in the body paragraph one, you should try to talk about some benefits of internet, and then we can switch to some negative aspect of internet in terms of social things or society. Okay, then our topic will be covered somewhere. So let's start. The benefits of the internet in terms of increased communication are clear. With people connected across the globe. Yes, the positivity of internet in terms of what? In terms of increased communication are very clear, because people can now connect with each other across the globe. Okay, in past, communication was only possible by phone or mail, which entailed time and expenses. Entailed means which involved, okay, which involved time and expense. It is usually meant just keeping in contact with those people already known to you. Okay, when you are communicating through mails or your phones, you are able to connect people you know already. But with the internet, this has changed dramatically. Now, why we are using the word dramatically, students? We can write changed also, but this word gives more attraction to your essay if you use some extraordinary words. Now, it has changed, okay, but how dramatically it has changed means to a large extent it has got changed. Email and social networking sites such as Facebook and MSN have created online communities that are global in scale, and they have fostered communication between people and countries that we would not have thought possible in not too distant past. Okay, like with internet, things have changed dramatically. Networking sites such as Facebook and MSN and other platforms, you can include Instagram, you can include some other social websites, they have taken people together. Okay. Now, the body paragraph number two. This is body paragraph two. Now, we have discussed the positivity, right? But we cannot incline towards the positive side, because a lot of thing will be on the negative aspect as well. That said, or you can write over here, having said that, okay? There is no doubt in my mind that this has had negative impacts on social interaction. Now, we have come to our main topic. People, especially younger generation, spend hours of their time online chatting or on forums. Yes, people nowadays, and especially younger generation, because you know the influence of internet is more on the younger generation. So you have to keep this thing in mind that people, but particularly the youngsters or younger generation, they spend hours of their time online chatting and on forums. Although this can be beneficial, it is certainly not the same as real interaction with human beings and does not involve the same skills. It is important that the children have and maintain real friendships in order to develop their own personal interpersonal skills. Then it is important that children should not adhere to only internet connections, but they should focus on their real friendships, their real life interactions. Not only this, it can also have negative effects on local communities if people are spending more time in communicating online and not mixing with the neighborhood, and possibly lead to the feeling of isolation for those individuals who do not have a real person to turn in times of need. See, internet relationships are only limited to the time when you have an internet connection. For example, you are at home and you come across some situations, some problems, and you want to call out for people for help. It is not the internet friends. They're not internet friends who are going to come first. They will come second, because it will take time for them to reach and communicate. So it will be your neighbors who will be in need of an hour. It will be your parents. It will be your family, sisters, brothers as well. So according to that, the real interaction should be among the in-life people. All right. So to mix with the neighborhood, it's very important that you get connected with them and not spend a lot of time on the internet, but on interacting with the people. Now, last but not the least, we are to the conclusion, because we covered our important aspects. This essay is about 270 words approximately. and that is good to go for your descriptive examination. You need not to write in an exaggerated manner. You need not to write in a very short manner. It should be just up to the mark. To conclude, now generally, as I told you, when you write conclusion, you can use certain words like to conclude, to sum up, to encapsulate. You can write like this. To conclude, I believe that internet has undoubtedly been beneficial, but there are good reasons to be concerned about social interaction in our societies. It is therefore important that we maintain a balance between our online life and contact with real human beings. Now, the conclusion part consists of your own perspective. Now, what is your own perspective? Do you think a person should refrain from internet connection and totally switch to real time, or exclude real time connections and come to the online connections? No, it should be a balance of both. You should make a balance in order to maintain your both life, offline lives and your online lives as well. Okay, so we have to maintain a balance between our online life and our contact with the real human beings. Okay, students, I hope you have understood this today's sample one essay. Now we will move to other essay. Let's start now. Very, very interesting topic. It is technological development. Students, this is also a very common topic in the examination because a lot of questions surround this idea. The examiner might not give you the topic like write about technological development. He will frame a sentence as I have always been telling you. He can tell how technological development has influenced our life. This is the common question that can be framed from this topic because you know, we are totally dependent on technology. So they can give you questions like how technology has affected human lives. Is it a positive effect? Is it a negative effect? How lives have changed due to technological advancement? So all these topics can be framed from this general topic. That's why I have taken this topic. And while reading the essay, you will gather content so that in exam, if you get any topic related to technological advancement, you will be in position to jumble up your ideas of the essay that you have just prepared. And you will be in position to write a good essay according to the exact topic given by the examiner. So this is how your exact essay should look like. Let's move on to the first introduction part of the essay and discuss it in detail. Yes. So the topic starts about technology development. So definitely in the introduction part, you have to talk about the advancement of technology. Let's read out. Developments in technology over many years have dramatically changed the world that we live in. And some people think that earlier advances in technology have had a greater impact and been more beneficial to the lives of ordinary people than more recent changes. However, I partially agree with this as the advantages and influence on people's life actually depends on a particular area of technology. Now, in this essay, we are going to discuss about technological advancement, but in a specific context. That context is that whether the recent advances are more beneficial or the previous technological advances were beneficial. So let's start. There is no doubt, this is first paragraph, first body paragraph, B1 I'm writing over here. There is no doubt. See, these kind of words are very important. These phrases give an impact to the examiner about an essay writing. Okay, so you can include your word without any doubt. There is no doubt. Okay, like these. There is no doubt that some earlier advances in technology have been very influential, such as those related to technology around home. Devices such as washing machines, fridges, now here you can write refrigerators as well, it will be more impactful. Washing machines, fridges, and freezers, central heating, microwaves, and televisions were invented many years ago. And now nearly every household has all or some of these in their home, making life much easier. Though they have been improved over time, they still carry out the same purpose as and when they were first invented. So yes, there is no doubt that the earlier advances in technology were very influential. We never had refrigerators. We never had washing machines. But in the past, these inventions took place. And still today, these inventions are irreplaceable because now almost every house have at least, every house has at least one of these equipments or all. So the past, like, you know, past inventions were really important. Okay, so let's move ahead now. Yes, body paragraph two. In this particular essay, we have taken three body paragraphs. Body paragraph two. Another example is that of medicine. Despite the fact that there have been groundbreaking recent medical development, such as that connected to research into genes and stem cells, the benefits to the average person are still many years away. The most influential impacts on health have been earlier technological developments of the past, which remain today. These are the ability to treat so many injuries and diseases and carry out organ transplants in hospitals. It is these that have benefits on so many lives and will for decades to come. So in the past invention, there was one very common example was the example of medicine. You know, the invention of so many remedies and medicines have created an influential impact on the life of a person. Earlier, organ transplant never used to happen, but it happened in the past invention. Organ transplant was a major thing, okay? It is these that have benefits on so many lives and will for decades to come. Okay, so students, I hope you have got this paragraph as well. Now, because this essay contains a lot of information, you may include or may not include body paragraph number three. So this is body paragraph number three. However, now because we have discussed about past inventions, it's important to discuss about today's invention, because this was what our topic is revolving around. However, if we look at some more recent developments, now if we look at the current developments in technology, they have had much greater influence than the past. Now in the past, the inventions were like washing machines and your microwaves, etc. So these were like very beneficial, but the recent advances are more beneficial. For example, there is the phone, which was a significant development when invented, helping many people. However, although invented many years ago, technological developments over the last few decades have enabled the phone to now be mobile and connected to internet. Now, first of all, phone is an old invention, right? But what was a recent invention connected to phone is that now phones turn into cell phones. You can carry them. Their mobility increased, right? Also, they started to be connected to internet, which again took the technological advancement to another level. This has had incredible impacts. Incredible means extremely outstanding impacts, something which you cannot believe, unbelievable impacts on the way people live their lives, with people using phones for so many every activities and for connecting around the world. So this came out to be a very good advancement in technology. Now comes the conclusion part. In conclusion, I would argue that although some older technological developments are important, some new ones are too. The impacts on ordinary people's lives therefore depends on type of technology in question. Basically, it doesn't matter whether the technological advancement is older or a new one, which is important or which is not important. It's not in our hand. We cannot give a correct answer to this. The whole sole answer is that it totally depends upon the usage. If the usage of a particular thing is important for you, that particular technology will be very, very worth for you. Okay, so this is the matter of type of technology, not the time of technology, that when it actually started and when not. So students, I hope you have understood this sample essay as well. So if you get any technological essay or technological development essay, its influences, you can frame out certain ups and downs things, and then you can frame a very good essay. Now it's time to move ahead and move on to the third sample essay, or today's final essay, which we are going to discuss in today's video. So without wasting much time, let's move on to the other essay. Essay number 3, working from home. Yes, this is not a common topic, students, but it can be a common topic for the upcoming examination. Reason being, this pandemic situation made people go through this situation, this particular situation of working from home. And as a result, this topic now comes under the category of a normal, common and interesting topic to be given by the examiner. Yes, so in this particular essay, we shall be discussing the possible advantages and disadvantages of working from home. Let's start an essay. This is how your essay should look like: an introduction, body paragraph 1, 2, 3, and conclusion. Now, here the introduction is a little small. You can include a lot of statements in your introduction over here. That is totally up to you. I will give you some ideas how you can stretch up your introduction. Now, this introduction is very, very short and brief because they have directly jumped to the topic. Now, I'll give you some options where you can include something else in your introduction. First, let's read this introduction. In the present age, it is common for people to work from home because of advances in technology. On balance, I would argue that this has more negative impacts than positive. Okay, you can substitute this introduction with another introduction. You can write like this, a student. Listen carefully to my conversation now. You can start with the current situation. Like, the pandemic had been a worse time to many. And at this time, technology served as a great help to the employed people. People started to work from home, thereby not affecting their job lives or employment lives. Okay? In the present age, it is common for people to work from home because of advancement in technology. Now you can balance out that it has a negative aspect also and some positive aspect as well. Okay, paragraph number 1, that is your body paragraph 1. Now, in the body paragraph 1, you shall start with advantages, okay? Because whenever anything has positive and negative aspect, always start with the positive and then go with the negative and finally a mixed review, okay? One advantage of working from home is the freedom it provides. Of course, the biggest advantages of working from home, yet you have freedom. You are in the comfort zone of your home, okay? But if you are in a job, you are working under somebody. So a lack of freedom is definitely there. Home workers can organize their work around their home life as they can stop or start work as they please. Now, for example, if you're working from home, you can divide your schedule. You can take your meals at a proper time. You can divide your proper time period. Okay. You can stop your work for a while, take up rest and then restart. So like this, you can manage. You're flexible. Thus, if, for example, they have children, they can easily arrange to them and pick them up from the school. For example, if you are a parent and you want to pick your child to us from a school, but when you are in a job, you cannot do so, right? Because you have to ask your boss that I need 5 minutes break or I need a break of these minutes. But when you are at home, you can stop your work for a while, go to pick your children, come back and start your work. Or you know, you can manage your work. You can manage that time period, right? They can also undertake any other task that they need to during the day, such as doing the laundry or shopping and then finish the work later. You can manage your work. If you want to go for shopping, you cannot do so while you're in a job. So, but when you're working from home, you can understand, you can make your schedule. For example, you want to go to shopping. So, and you're working right now. So you can think and manage that, okay, if I spare 1 hour to shopping, I can devote my later 1 hour to my work. So when you come back, then you can start your work or you can do your work in the later hours whenever you are comfortable. Overall, then, employees have more control over their lives without any doubt. Now, this paragraph will discuss about some disadvantages. Despite these positive factors, however, there are a number of disadvantages. The first of these is the fact that those who work at home, okay, those who work at home nearly all the time will not be mixing with the colleagues. When people are at work, they're always surrounded by others, but at home, an employee is likely to be alone most of the time. This may lead to the feeling of loneliness due to lack of interaction. Yes, when you do a job, when you are in the office, you get to be social. You learn to be social. You learn to be connected with people. Also, you feel more competitive. The feeling of competition is missing when you are at home. You might not work with full enthusiasm at times. Okay? Another drawback is the fact that one may have less influence in the company. It is often the case that important decisions arise in the spur of the moment as unexpected issues arise. If an employee is not there, others may have to step in. If this occurs on a regular basis, the employee's contribution to the company may decline, meaning a higher probability of getting overlooked for some things like promotion. Now, when you are sitting back at home and doing 100%, that goes only 99 or 98%. That 2%, 3% is always missing. So when at times of promotion, you'll be overlooked because your hard work, your decision-making ideas will not be visible. But when you are practically present over there, you may show your active participation and contribution in different aspects. Now comes the conclusion part. In conclusion, although there are positives and negatives related to working from home, there are more negative impacts. Employees should therefore consider carefully whether working from home is the best choice. Or now you can include in your conclusion that however it has positive and negative impacts both, a person should take a wise decision of working at home depending upon the situation. If there a situation arises and the practical need is to be at home, then a person should choose being at home. Otherwise, the exposure of job is most important. Sitting back at home does not give you that confidence to work and so much credibility to the work. So that's why these all things you can include in your working from home aspects. Okay. So students, I hope you have got clear idea about this particular essay and you are clear with the concept as well. So thank you, students. In the next class, we'll study some more essays and then we'll begin with our other descriptive context like precise writing and letter writing.